Now let's start. Thank you very much for coming today. And then today's topic, I will show you that. Here we go. How to protect yourself from evil spirits, the modern exorcist. I will tell you this story based on this book. If you like. Okay, thank you. Like this? Okay. What can I say? Yeah. I'm talking that this story based on this book. If you like, you can get this book after this seminar. Okay? That is Modern Day Exorcist. Because this is also very serious for the people, even modern days. And sometimes people feel something evil, but you cannot tell because there are no way. If you go to the psychologist or something, then they will tell you, okay, I will give you medicine, right? But it's not solution. Maybe almost all people think that. Then today I will show you this story based on the teachings of Master Riho Kawa. He's a founder of Happy Science. As the DVD said, he already published over 1,000 books. And in Japan, every year, he got million seller. And then he also visited many countries. And he already has over 100 countries, his followers. Then, regarding his activities, I have another story, but today is not day, someday I will tell you. But he said, please read it, about 70% of diseases are caused by spiritual possession. And 99% of family problems are influenced by evil spirits. You may be very surprised, because it is truth. It is truth. Like this. Everybody in this world, we are influenced by many kinds of spiritual beings. Of course, including the angels, or sometimes God. But sometimes, we are possessed by evil spirits, like this. Then, today I will show you, why does spiritual possession occur? That is a basic question. I know many religious persons, like Christian monks and Muslim people, a Buddhist, can tell you that kind of story. But unfortunately, of course, including the psychologist, cannot tell you why. But we can tell you the reason. I will show you conclusion first. Why does spiritual possession occur? Here we go. Because you are governed by emotion, have negative thoughts, and think of only you. That is the conclusion. But you may be wondering, I need more explanation. Yes, I will tell you more explanation about that. Why you are governed by evil spirits and got trouble. Do you know this? The law of same wavelength attraction. Okay, I will show you the Master Oka's, one of the Master Oka's lecture. And he also made many, many lectures for 26 years, now over 2,000. For 26 years. Then this is one of them. I will show you his explanation first.
If I am to go into greater detail of the reasons why possession occurs, I cannot do so without mentioning the law of same wavelength attraction. This law is a major teaching of happy science, and is one that I would like you all to grasp a clear understanding of. Although you are currently living on Earth as three-dimensional beings, your mind is always in contact with the world beyond because it is the central core of your soul. The mind can be described as an electromagnet, which always generates spiritual radio waves. The mind is in a state of constant exchange with the spirit world. The two are affecting and being affected by each other. The question of just what this electromagnet attracts to it provides us with the key to understanding possession. If you wish to know what kind of spirit is in possession of you at the moment, or what kind of spirit is likely to come to you, all you have to do is examine the state of your mind. In most cases, your mind will be in contact with spirits that share the same type of thoughts. This law of same wavelength attraction is quite difficult to comprehend, but an instinctive understanding of the subject is quite accurate. Consider a television. If the television is not tuned into a certain channel, it won't show any image. But when the channel is tuned properly, the image is quite clear. The same is true of the radio. If it's tuned in properly, the FM programs can be heard. But if the frequencies do not match, you will hear nothing.
Do you understand? That is the same system of radio wave or TV station. Okay, you have a channel in your mind. Then, if you want to watch Channel 7, what will you do to see, to watch the Channel 7? Maybe turn the channel, like using this one, then push button number 7, right? This is the system. So you emit, you have emitted the specific wavelength. That is called the vibration. Sometimes you feel that. If you see the someone who have strong anger, you feel that. That is a wavelength. Everybody has. So then, like this. If you have yellow mind, you can attract yellow people. If you have red mind, you can attract red people. And if you have blue mind, you can attract blue people around you. That is a law. That's why in another world, in spirit world, you can go to the specific world. Then you can see the similar people in another world. That's why all Saints Giants explain that is, if you have good mind, loving mind, you can see loving people after death. That's called heavenly world. But if you don't have good mind, like anger, hatred, doubt, something like that, so you may go to hell, then you may see bad people, evil people. That is the law of same waves attractions. So please remember that. That is the key word. Then I will show you another lecture regarding this by Master Iho Okawa.
Possession takes place when the frequencies of the mind come into alignment. So what is the main thing to be careful of? Well, there is an envious mind, one that is filled with envy for others. Next is a heart that is always filled with dissatisfaction and complaint. Then there is the kind of heart that is forever cursing or abusing others, hurting them with bad words. There is a cynical heart, and there is a heart that suffers from a persecution complex. Basically, the majority of people who are spiritually disturbed suffer from persecution complexes. They believe that they're always bullied and that they always lose out. The other side of this complex is a tendency to always put the blame on others. They blame their parents, their friends, their teachers, their superiors at work, their colleagues, their lovers, the environment, their job, the economy, anything but themselves. They think it is never their fault. It's always somebody else who deserves the blame. It is people who have a tendency to avoid any responsibility themselves that hellish spirits find easy to approach. Another kind of negative heart, an angry heart. Everybody loses their temper at times, but people who become angry on a regular basis, who are always in a rage, are generally in tune with hell. People who are filled with unreasonable rage will find that they attract hell spirits. In this way, people who soon lose their temper, who say terrible things, who complain, always blaming others for their misfortune, will be approached by hell spirits. The opposite is also true. People with a low sense of self-esteem, a low opinion of themselves, people who think they are no good, who are rubbish, who think they are beyond help, and that it would have been better if they were never born, will also find that they attract hell spirits. Their hearts are also hidden under dark clouds. According to Buddhist doctrine, the main factors that create a negative mind can be summed up as greed, anger, foolishness, pride, doubt, and false view. Greed is excessive desire. Everybody possesses desire, but if it's taken too far, it appears very ugly to others. He is too greedy, he doesn't do much work, but he's always trying to get a rise. He's trying to make money without doing anything. A favorite theme in samurai movies is that of the local administrator who gets defeated by a virtuous hero. In these stories, the administrator is generally greedy. Those who are willing to break the laws enforce to make a profit. This kind of person can be said to suffer from excessive greed. The next delusion is anger, about which I spoke earlier. It's the kind of heart that suddenly flies into a rage, is prone to possession by animal spirits, particularly snakes. Next, we have foolishness. This refers to the kind of person who makes many mistakes and creates their own suffering. In particular, there is foolishness with regard to religious truth. There are many people who claim the opposite to religious truth, who believe the opposite of what I preach. They think that pleasure is everything in this world. They devote themselves to pleasure and do not search for anything spiritual. People who only seek happiness through material or physical things are fools. This is what is meant by foolishness. Even though they may have a high IQ and be able to excel in their studies at school, a person may still be a fool. Pride stems from the heart of conceit. The conceit brings them down, makes them suffer. The road to hell can be created through suffering. There are many people who fail in their aims due to conceit. The next is doubt, and when I talk of it in this context, I'm generally referring to the doubt of the truth of Buddha. But it also includes suspicion, a tendency to suspect others and not to be tractable. The final factor, false view, refers to somebody who has a wrong outlook. There are numerous mistaken outlooks, and some of them are taught in schools. These become political and economic ideologies, and sometimes they're adopted by organizations or religious groups who teach mistaken ideas. Once you've become possessed by a mistaken idea, you'll see everything wrongly. For this reason, somebody who is a member of a mistaken religion will find it most difficult to achieve enlightenment. I think that salvation will prove impossible until they decide to leave the organization. It'll be hard to achieve enlightenment while in a gang of robbers. So it'll be difficult to find the truth while in a group of people who believe in a false ideology. There are many false views in the world today. Even among intellectuals, false views are extremely common. The worst disseminator of wrong views is journalism, due to the mistaken reports that appear in the newspapers, on the television and the like. The world is flooded with false ideas. As a result of the ensuing confusion, hell is able to regenerate itself regularly. You should think of all these delusions as the foundations for a negative heart. In addition, on an emotional level, sudden rage, complaining, and placing the blame on others also denote a negative mind. Basically, somebody whose words, actions, and lifestyles are bad can be said to express a bad heart.
So, you may be wondering some poisons you may have bad, but for example, he mentioned about doubt. Then, that is not try to threaten you. Okay. That is the explanation of the difference between humankind and animal. Do you know the difference between animal and the humankind? What is that? The most typical one. It's difficult? Yes. The difference between the humankind, animal, there are many, many things, but most important one is, yes?
Humans have faith in something higher like God. Mm-hmm. Animals cannot share that faith.
Yes, that's true. Yeah, you are a good student. Then, faith, especially humankind, can believe in invisible things like love, courage, and so on. But animals can react to live in this world. Animal can see just a visible thing and react to that. But humankind can control their own mind, just not a reaction, right? Then humankind can believe in invisible thing. That is a difference, typical difference between animal and humankind. So, that's why we need to be more precious. That is a way to be closer to God. That's why if you react only to just a visible thing and governed by emotion, that is not good attitude as humankind. Then, next question you may have is here. What is evil spirit? See, evil spirit is a spirit in hell, or an earthbound spirit who thinks of only one's own benefit and never smiles. Okay? An angel is a spirit in heaven, or a loving spirit who thinks of others' benefit and always smiles. That is quite different between the existence of the hell and existence in heaven. If you want to recognize who is evil spirits, who is angels, check his mind, his face, her face, okay? Whether she is smiling or not. Or if you want to check, you can go to heaven or hell after death. You can check your face. You can smile. That is the difference. So, but I don't want to make you the threatened because make you afraid because of this. Because sometimes people think hell is eternal world. I don't think so. Of course, heaven and hell exist. But hell is a kind of hospital to restore your mind. The truth said, even if you realize, oh, I'm in the hell, like that, after death, if you reflect yourself and restore your mind, you can go to heaven. That is the law of same wavelength. So, please, note that. Because sometimes, hell is, sometimes people think that hell is eternal punishment. That is not. Okay. Hell is a kind of the people who got like a illness. So you can cure, you can restore, even after this. But I suggest to you, before going to another world, please reflect yourself. That's what I want to tell you today. Then, to do so, to become the heavenly existence. This is a key word. Minimize the time thinking of yourself and maximize the time thinking of others. That is very revolutionary idea for humankind. Usually, almost all people think of only myself. That is a maybe natural attitude, I think. But if you can change your mindset from taking love from others to giving love to others without expecting anything in return, you can be an angel. Very easy, but to practice it, that is very hard. That is the key word. No evil spirit can possess you when you think of others' happiness. But evil spirit can sneak into your mind when you think of your own happiness, your own, only your own benefit. That is quite different. And then you may wondering that one question. All right? If you are a student, you need to think of yourself, your future. You need to study a lot. I'm telling you about the motivation in your mind. Why you need to study? For your money? For your fame? For your title? Please remember that saints or giants. Why? Saints and giants study hard every day. Because they want to make others happy. So that is a golden rule without exception. In another lecture, Master Oka said, please do not think of yourself. Instead, think of others' happiness. If you cannot study a lot from happy science, please remember only one sentence. That is, don't think yourself. Instead, think of others' happiness. If you want to become happy or happier. And then, now we got over 100 countries, and then we have over millions of people in 100 countries. They are proof. They are evidence. So please try. That is a very, very key point. And when you practice it, you have never been possessed by evil spirits. So, but your question is here. Then, how to change my mindset to protect myself from evil spirits. Okay, I will show you example. Life story of Ms. A. She's also one of members of Happy Science. I got a letter from Tokyo, okay? A woman, let's call her Ms. A, had divorced and returned to her hometown. The reason of divorce was her ex-husband's love affair. She felt she had been thrown away and lost the will to live. She led empty days as she could not even remember whether she had eaten meal or not. Her body was always heavy, and every day she suffered from headache. Furthermore, she began to hear a scary whisper in her ears, like, "Kill yourself." Although she took medical checkup, they could not find anything usual. She also visited a shaman, but they could not solve the problems, who had psychic power. To make matters worse, she was tortured with a sense of loneliness because no one could understand her. One day, she finally ran into a flower shop near her house, where her cousin was running. They had been good friends since their childhood. Ms. A said, "I don't know why only I can hear a voice of spirit. You believe in what I'm saying, don't you?" Then, unexpectedly, a customer in the flower shop told her, "Why don't you meet Mrs. S? She's a member of Happy Science." Mrs. S was one of Ms. A's classmates, and she was living near Ms. A's house. Then she visited Mrs. S and confided all of her sufferings. Mr. and Mrs. S listened to her carefully, and their affluent kindness and love let her feel peace of mind, which she could not have felt for a long time. Then, Ms. A took devotion to the three treasures at Happy Science. And that is a kind of decided to become a member, devotee member, and enter the path of faith. Soon after, she began to learn the truth. She got to know about spiritual possessions and the law of same wavelength attraction. She was shocked to realize that the cause of spiritual possession lied in her hellish mind. She made a strong determination to throw away her negative mind that attracted evil spirits by studying the truths and practicing self-reflection hard. However, every time she opened a book of truths, she fell asleep. She strived hard, and finally she could read through the laws of the sun. She was so moved with a lot of great teachings about the laws of the mind that she became more eager to learn the truth. But things did not go well as she wanted. No sooner had she turned on the player to listen to Master's lecture than she fell asleep. Even if she wanted to go to a satellite seminar of Master Riho Okawa, she felt her body was too heavy to get up. "Why is it so difficult for me to control my mind?" Miss A felt impatient on herself, and she was vast in tears. However, she had a strong hope to share the precious faith and the light view of life with her children, whom she had troubled about her divorce. I'll make every effort to restore myself, she pledged in her mind and kept on learning the truth and practicing self-reflection. One day, while she was reading The Laws of the Sun, she was deeply impressed by the sentence, "Love is above all a matter of giving." It's because she had been wanting to take love from others. "I want to change my mind," she began to reflect on herself silently and in the process of continual self-reflection. She could find out the conflict with her mother. Ms. A had felt that her mother hadn't loved her. That's because she had three brothers and her mother had been always kind to them, but only to Ms. A. Her mother usually complained. Moreover, Ms. A had been compared with her smart brothers, and her mother often said to her that she had nothing good. As a result, Ms. A had unconsciously begun to think that her mother hadn't needed her, and berated herself. Perhaps in order to hide her inferiority complex, and she gradually began to act as if she had wanted to show off her excellence. For example, when she had a meeting with others, she tried to say her opinion first. She often intruded her thought to her ex-husband in order to be appreciated by him. "The root cause of my spiritual possession is taking love from others, which is based on my inferiority complex," she found out the root cause of the problem. "I have to overcome the conflict with my mother by any means," with firm determination. She tried to discover good points of her mother and write them down in a notebook. At first, she could not rid herself from hatred toward her mother. But gradually, she began to realize another image of her mother, who brought up four children all by herself. To tell the truth, Ms. A's parents had lived separately because of her father's love affair, and her mother had worked very hard to bring up her children. But when her mother started to run a pub, Ms. A could not stand that and kept asking her mother to stop that kind of work. Since then, she had blamed her mother. However, her mother had been patient with saying a word. And when Ms. A told her mother that she decided to drop out of high school because of their financial condition, her mother said, "All an inheritance that I can leave for you is education." And she had managed to make money to have let her graduate from high school. When she recalled that, Ms. A realized that the reason why her mother had always complained to her was her mother had trusted her. Having thought she had been the most reliable child of four children. "My mother loved me so much." Tears streaming down from her eyes purified and healed her mind, and a sense of gratitude filled up inside her. Suddenly, chronic heaviness of her body and headache disappeared, as if it had been illusion. This was the very moment that evil spirits got away from her. However, it didn't mean her spiritual possession was completely solved. She had to struggle with herself for another half year. During the struggle, when she had worried about the future and became negative, her body got heavy again, and she began to suffer from headache. And as she read books of the truth and practiced self-reflection, she gradually became cheerful and her mind became warm. After a while, she suddenly sensed something came of her. And at the moment, she realized she had been possessed again, and she got discouraged with the fact. In spite of such situation, Ms. A never gave up and kept on learning the truth and reflecting on herself. Afterward, she met a man who shared the same faith and married him. Now she enjoys family utopia with her wonderful husband and children. The mind filled with gratitude is essential to overcome spiritual possession. With this precious lesson, Ms. A is actively sharing the importance of exploring the light mind in life, aiming to make others happier. How was this story? Good. Right. Amazing? Mm-hmm. Yes. Also, everybody can do it. That's what I'm telling you. So, quick review, this amazing story for you. Okay. Here we go. First, she made strong decision to change her own mind. That is the starting point. If you don't want to change your mind, but want to change others, it's not a good way, right? That is the starting point. If you blame to others, if you complain to your situation, then nothing starts. So second step, she tried to get loving mind instead of taking off love. Then, to do so, study the truth and start self-reflection to change her mindset. Because we cannot change others' mind at all, but you can change your own mind. That's why this is a very good point to study the truth. Truth means, of course, spiritual truth and self-reflection. And truth has double meaning. One is a spiritual truth. Another is what God or Buddha has been thinking. Understand God's mind. Understand Buddha's love. That is the truth. So then, prayer and gratitude. She prayed a lot in temple of happy science. And give gratitude to the Lord. Because she thought that is a homework given by God or Buddha. Then she can give gratitude to the Lord. That is the last step. Then, as I told you, loving mind, decision, please decide to have loving mind instead of taking love. That is a very first point for everybody. So that you can avoid negative influence. If you feel, now I got some negative influence or effective from others, please decide, okay, I will change my mindset from taking love to giving love. That is called loving mind. Study the truth. To change your mindset, you need to know what God has been thinking, what Buddha has been thinking, how much God loves you. How much Buddha loves you. That is very important point. Without understanding God's love, Buddha's love, you cannot change your own situation, your own mind. Then she reflected herself how much she had taken love from others. So that is a very good point. But I dare tell you, self-reflection doesn't mean punishment. Okay, sometimes people think if I reflect myself, I have to punish myself like a bad child. It's not. Because we all humankind are children of God. That means originally we are very pure and beautiful. But during the training, we got some dust, right? Bad mind, bad reaction. That's why we need a self-reflection. Yes, self-reflection is the way to restore your mind, not punishment. Find your tendency of your soul. And then, if you find the wrong way of thinking, that is called a tendency, you need to change that from current mind to original one. That is the self-reflection. Then, through these ways, you can get this mind. Very beautiful. Originally, you had these kinds of mindset as gift from God. But you forgot because of long journey called life. Then, please believe me, you have been given this present from God. So today, I suggest you practice. Just watch your mind. And what kind of mindset do you have now? That is also a very important point. If you realize now you have wrong mindset, you can be possessed by evil spirits because of the law of same wavelengths. Be careful about that. But if you can remove that, you can be very fine and do good every day. And as a conclusion, you can complete your mission. Everybody has mission without exception. Everybody has purpose of one's life. To complete them, you should be happy. You should be cheerful. To avoid a negative mindset, you need to check yourself. That is that self-reflection. Then today, since we have a very short time, so just 3 minutes, you can see your mindset. Very good, right? Because as I suggest to you, when you practice kind of self-reflection or prayer, so you need pray to your guardian guiding spirits so that you can avoid attack from evil spirits. That is my suggestion, recommendation. So then, but you may wonder, if you find the wrong way of thinking, negative thoughts, how can I change it? It's a very short time, too short change it. Yes, it is. Then you need to practice this way every day so that you can avoid possession by evil spirits. But you need to know more. You want to know more, right? Yes, I will show you one way to reflect yourself, change your mindset, and then remove your negative mindset. That is, as Kellen mentioned, some of you joined that, right? And then that is laws of cause and effect. I told you already, 100% of self-responsibility. That is a golden rule to remove your negative thoughts. Because, okay, now you have the specific the state of mind, like negative or positive, happy or unhappy, like that, happy or miserable, or like that. Okay. For example, if you find that is a reward you got now, all right. If you feel something miserable, you need to ask yourself why. Why you got such a miserable mindset right now? Because that is a result, instance you got. You are student. You got F score and told off by your teacher. Like that. Okay? So why you got F score? Because then you need to ask that. Because that is a condition. Condition means what you have made effort. So you did not, you have not made effort so much. You realize that. Yes. It was not enough to get A score or even B score. You got F score. Then you need to ask again, why? Why I could not make effort? Because the cause, what you thought, you did not have, you have not had dream or goal. Then, since you have not had dream, you could not have the mind try to make effort more and more enthusiastically. Then you got F score. Then you have had miserable mind. That is just an example, but you can think of that. Use this way. That is laws of cause and effect. Okay, check your mind first, whether you are happy or not. Then if you feel something miserable or unhappy, you can ask why, why, why. Then you can find the cause. Okay, that means everything comes from what you have thought in your mind. That will determine whether you are happy or not. Then you need to make bright future. That means you need to change your mindset, the root of your phenomenon you encounter. Okay? So that cause, if you have positive mindset, in that case, you want to become a prime minister of this country, or big CEO of big company, like that. Then if you have that, you can make effort to achieve your goal. Then you get A score. Then teachers praises you. So you got a reward, happy mind, right? That is a way of thinking, the Buddhist way, called self-reflection. That is a way. Then, maybe sometimes, that is a rare case, but you are governed by evil spirit. That is a very easy to remove them, just to change your mind. But it's a little bit difficult, but you can do it, I believe. But sometimes, we are affected by Satan or devil. That has stronger power than just evil spirits. In that case, what should you do? Masa Okawa show you the way. That is prayer with faith. So that means if you feel bad feeling from the strong evil something, then you can not do anything. Just lay down in your bed. You cannot give love to others. So what should you do? Just a prayer, okay? So faith does not mean that just believe in the strange thing. What do you think? What is the real meaning of faith? As Jesus Christ said, as Shakyamuni Buddha said, as Mohammed said, same thing. Common point you can look for. That is, accept God's love, accept Buddha's love, accept Allah's love. Believe in God, Buddha, or Allah, whatever you call. We call it El Cantare, the source of all light, source of all energy. Always loves you, regardless of your gender, nation, even the religious identity. He always loves you. Just accept it. Then you can get the strong energy, strongest energy in this world. Because I'm very sad, because sometimes people think we are punished by God or something like that. Never. God has never, Buddha has never, Allah has never punished us at all. Originally, we are children of God. But we ourselves sometimes disturb His love. We have a big board on the top of your head, and I don't want to see His love because I'm a bad child, like that. But just remove this board from your head and accept His love. That is a faith. Okay, very easy. That's what all religions suggested to you. That's why religion is very important for modern people. Modern people sometimes misunderstand that faith is just religious people forced to meet, change, and combat my belief or something like that. That doesn't mean faith. Faith means accept the fact God, Buddha, or Allah always loves us. That it. Then your prayer can be very effective because you accept He loves you. Why God doesn't assist you? But sometimes, even if you pray to the Lord, pray to God, pray to Buddha, sometimes He cannot give you answer. What do you think? Because He expects you develop. We, all humankind, came here from heavenly world. No one came here from hell. We are children of God, originally very pure. So we can become very pure. You will realize when you accept His love. That's why we need faith to realize that, oh, I am a child of God. I am a very lovable person from the viewpoint of God. Right? So then I will show you one of Master's lecture.
Since ancient times, it has been said that there is a huge tree in the universe that could be called the cosmic tree. One tree, one enormous tree, that is the tree of life. They say this tree exists in the universe. If you take a look at this big tree from an even greater perspective, its branches extend well beyond this earth to all parts of the universe. But if you look at it from the viewpoint of Earth, it appears to be one big tree growing like a pillar among the spirit group we call Earth.
The name of this huge tree of life is El Cantare. It is the origin of life on Earth. All spiritual energy flows from here. There are many large branches coming from this huge tree of life called El Cantare. These big branches are races, and these branches represent the various races of different countries. That branch divides again countries, or groups of people that share a certain idea. Your own personality exists on the very end of a branch of this giant cosmic tree. But just before the point where your branch splits off, there are several other small branches growing. These are where the people that you call your soulmates exist. There are people who you are certainly and absolutely destined to meet at least once in your life. The life training that that person offers is necessary for you. Some appear as kind supporters, while others teach you strictly or give you hardships. However, there are people that you absolutely must meet. In some ways, this is a workbook of problems in your life. That is why I preach to you about love. I tell you to love each other. And when I say that, I mean that you are not strangers to each other. Actually, we are all connected. Somewhere, at some point in time, your original life energy is connected, and many of you have met before in many different eras. When a new Dharma is taught, like it is now in this life, many of these people are reborn. During the period of Lamu, Thoth, Hermes, or Buddha, you all met before, and you are now meeting here with a different appearance or role, perhaps switching gender or swapping parent-child roles.
Okay, I will show you. This is a cosmic tree, as he mentioned. Then, sometimes, like this, this branch try to cut off other branches. It is one of religion, okay, one of religions. Called Christianity, Muslim, Buddhism, or something like that. But this branch try to cut off other branches. This branch criticize strongly other branches. But they are connected to each other. That's why God descended to this earth sometimes, and then he preached the law to the humankind. And that is the truth. So why don't you pray to him? You are affected by strong evil spirits. That is the source. Then, as I told you, if you pray every day, the Dharma of the right mind, you can polish your soul and refine your mind. That I have this one, Dharma of the right mind. You can find a way, and you can confirm that is effective or not. If you read it through, I guarantee you, if you read it through every day, like for 3 months, you can polish your soul and refine your mind, and you can restore your mind. Even the cancer has gone. We already have the evidence, proof that many people experience that. That's why many people joined that, like over millions of people. And then, as a first step, what I recommend you to read the short version. Short version means this includes 7 sutras inside, but this is only 3 prayers, like the Dharma of the right mind and the prayer to the Lord, prayer to guiding spirits. But still, it's very effective if you read it through every day. To get this one, you just sign up as a friendship member, and you can get it. And then you can try. That is not core member, but it is to become a member. And first step. Okay. Then quick review. Today's lesson, okay? To remove your negative thoughts or protect yourself from evil spirits, there are four steps. Okay, please note that in your mind. Remember, very effective, and you can see very strong that phenomenon. Sometimes miracle. Okay, if you practice this very sincerely. First, loving mind. Second step, study the truth. Third step, self-reflection. And if you got the strongest one, like Satan evils, you can pray. Pray with faith. Just accepting, believing God, Buddha, El Cantar, loves you, always loves you. So if you want to get the enlightenment, that is another way to remove your negative mindset. But this is a way to remove the negative influence. Sometimes people are struggling with a negative influence. Try to change others' mind, try to change your situation, but it's impossible. But you can change your mindset. Then that is a way to change others, change your situation, and remove your negative influences. Please try. Just believe and do it. Then you can get the result. Buddha or God can guarantee you. So please remember this important point.